Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about living world and classification of microbes. So what is the living world? The world surrounding us, the world which makes plants, animals, insects, small microbes, etc. This is the living world. And what is the classification of microbes? Classification of microbes means dividing the microbes or microorganisms into small groups. Now, why it is necessary to divide or classify the small organisms into small groups and subgroups? And what it is called? It is necessary because last time we have learned that all the living organisms on the earth has adopted according to the geographical regions, food ingestion and defense, etc. While adapting, many differences are observed in the organisms of the same species too. According to 2011 census, around 87 million species of living organisms are found on the earth, including land and sea. So to study such a vast number, it was essential to divide them into groups and small groups. So we created considering the similarities and differences among the living organism. So this classification is called as hierarchy of classification. So what it is based on? It is based on kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So firstly, for the most, who invented this binomial system of nomenclature? Carl Linnaeus invented binomial system of classification. Now students, what is binomial system of classification? Binomial system of classification, as you have learned in the last year, to give the name, scientific name, to a living organism. Now how we will write the names of this binomial nomenclature? How to write the nomenclature name? In the first part, the generic name comes, and then it comes in italic and capital always. In the second part, species names comes. For example, Homo sapiens. Homo is the generic name and sapiens is the species name, that is developing human, means we. So what is biodiversity and need of classification? Why there is a need of classification? To study the number of vast of organism, it is essential to divide them into groups and subgroups, as we have discussed earlier. Now what is biological classification? The process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups, it's called as biological classification. Now the two scientists, or the scientist who worked upon it, was Robert Harding Whittaker from 1920 to 1918. An American ecologist in 1969 divided living organisms into five groups. So while dividing them into five groups, he followed some criteria. So these criteria are complexity of cell structure, that is whether the organism is prokaryotic or whether the organism is eukaryotic. So prokaryotic means whether they are having the cell wall, and eukaryotic means they do not have the cell wall and they have the cell wall or nuclear membrane around them. The second criteria was based upon complexity of organisms, that is whether the organism is unicellular or the organism is multicellular. So what he did, the organisms which are unicellular, he put them into one group, and the organisms which are multicellular, he put them into another same group. The third level of criteria was mode of nutrition. Mode of nutrition means from where they get the energy. Some were autotrophic, means they were the producers. Some were saprophytic, that means they depended on dead and decaying matter for their mode of nutrition, and heterotrophic, who use autotrophs and heterotrophs or the carnivores or omnivores as their mode of nutrition. So this was the criteria. For example, some are vegetarian and some are non-vegetarian. So vegetarian people get the food from the veg food, and non-vegetarian get the nutrition from the non-vegetarian food. And some are the people who are both vegetarian and non-vegetarian, so they get the food from both the nutrition from both the foods. The fourth level of criteria was lifestyle, as they were the producers or they were the consumers or they were the decomposers. What he did, he put the producers in one group, he put the consumers in one group, he put the decomposers in one group. According to this, he divided the organisms into five groups. The next level of criteria was phylogenetic relationship. What is the meaning of phylogenetic relationship? Phylogenetic relationship means the development in the organism. That means from prokaryotic to eukaryotic. It means when the organism has born, he or the organism possess it, they are the prokaryotic cell structure. And after the development of the organism, he becomes the eukaryotic. So phylogenetic relationship, the development in the organism from the birth towards the developing stage, that is from prokaryotic to eukaryotic. Last is unicellular to multicellular. That is, while birth or before birth or during the birth period, the organism is unicellular, and after some period of time, the organism becomes multicellular. So this is called as phylogenetic relationship, which means the development in the cell structure of the organism from prokaryotic to eukaryotic and from unicellular to multicellular.